We got a Damon Daybreak coming in here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. A little bit of a tail to this one. I kind of wished it was otherwise, but sometimes these things happen. The folks that we are selling this for, we're selling it on consignment, which don't let that screw your head up. If you're looking for, we can still do trades, financing, we still do everything as though we were selling it ourselves. But folks purchased this RV in 2015. They got to enjoy one trip. And then, unfortunately, the gentleman of the household, his spirit is no longer with us since then. And it has sat, basically, untouched, unmolested, if you will, in an enclosed storage location since 2015. And the lady of the house finally reached a point where she said, you know what, it's just silly, I need to let this thing go. So they bought it with 10,600 miles. It still does not even have 11,000 miles on it. It was barely ever touched. Now, thankfully, in the meantime, it wasn't left to rot. Someone apparently had done, I'm trying to keep the sun out of your eyes there, sorry. Someone had done some attention preventative maintenance or whatever on it along the way. Like, the generator runs like a top. Everything in it seems to run great. There's a little bit of weathering on some of the decals, and that was sadly common when this was made, so it has nothing really to do with quality of previous ownership. It's just the quality of the decals that the whole industry really used at the time. But that had to have happened before the current owner had a hold of it, because again, they had it stored inside. The tires look great. The tires are not dry rotted. The roof is impeccable. The roof condition is absolutely amazing. You see that expansive one-piece windshield up here? That's giving us maximum views of our destination. The skin still has a lot of gleam to it, so I mean, obviously it wasn't kept outside where it was left to rot or anything. It would actually gleam more, but it's a bit chilly and slightly frosted on the skin currently. Interesting floor plan, really neat layout. You'll see that when we get inside. But typically you see slides on this side of the RV, not the other side. But what it's created is just the easiest storage compartments you can imagine. Now, you saw the front one was a big storage compartment, but then you have a pair of pass-throughs, which is not common on a gas motorhome. This being a gasser, you do have a drivetrain that runs through the belly, and you don't typically get... Now, obviously, there's the drivetrain hump there, but the fact is the chassis is large enough they could still do a pass-through. It's great for, like, picnic tables. Again, generator fires like a champ. That's a 5500 Onan. And these tires look spectacular. Lots of rubber left on the treads, a lot of rubber on the sneakers, and no sign of dry rotting or weather checking anywhere that I can detect. I mean, I'm not, I stayed at a Holiday Inn Express last night, but hey, I think we're fine. Again, the roof is absolutely impeccable. It actually still, to this day, has the original factory sealant in place, and it still looks good. That being said, due to the age of this, if you were going to keep it stored indoors again, I would say you'd probably get another year, maybe two out of it before you have to worry about replacing stuff. If you're going to have it stored where it has to be outdoors, I would recommend probably looking at doing some resealing on that roof within a year. Just as preventative. There's nothing there that makes me like, oh God, that's going to leak in a day or nothing like that. It's just as a just intelligent, logical, preventative maintenance. It'd be a good idea. What does this have for towing? We got a Traton V10. It's on a Ford chassis. So it's probably about 5,000 pound rated towing. I'd have to check. I'd have to see what I can look into. Older motorhomes like this where, you know, there's not just a book with the specs for this thing laying around anymore. It's sometimes difficult to get certain specifications like that out of here. Give our guys a call here, though, because there are ways you can calculate those sort of things. I just haven't been able to look them up yet. It's been a busy day, and I'm flying by the seat of my pants right now. And again, it is impressive, the glossiness remaining on the skin here. It's pretty sharp shape. Dual power entry step makes for easy coming and going. And something I like here, I actually see a lot of this on the Jayco Precept motorhomes that we carry here at Haylett RV, which really fit right into this class, are the really thin side corner beams that you see right there. It makes for maximum visibility while you're in transit, and that, so you can, like, if there's a little car, that little Geo Metro that always parks too close to you right here at a stoplight, you can see them. That being said, let's take a peek inside. Like I said, outside, really neat layout. Everything about it is like the opposite of what you see in, quote, the normal motorhome. But it works. Like, normally, this slide-out would be on the driver's side of the RV. And I walked in for a minute, I'm like, why would they do that? And then all of a sudden I realized, windows. All the windows are now on the door side. That makes sense. That's really smart. The other thing is, you don't have to worry about the slide-out accidentally crushing the driver's seat when you're, you know, getting ready to pack up and head out. Then I looked over here, and I saw what, I mean, normally, you normally see a very traditional sofa galley or kitchen slide, but it's not in the slide. And again, it just makes sense because it's very spacious, super functional in here. Provided I remember, I'm going to try to close the slide up at the end of the video so you folks get to see what it looks like in road mode, so to speak. But really different floor plan. Like this part right here, the way this kitchen kind of meets up with the cab area, it actually reminds me a lot of a little Class C. But then I started thinking about it. In transit, you're going to want to hop up. Maybe you want to get to that sink. Maybe you want to get to that fridge. They are now the closest things to the driving cabin area, as opposed to having to go halfway through the RV while it's going down the road. And it really makes a lot of sense. And I'm kind of surprised now that I've been in it. It hasn't been done more. It's a neat layout. I really like it. You do have dual air conditioners in here, so it should be pretty nice and comfortable, even in the hotter climates, Texas, Florida, Arizona type stuff. I mean, great kitchen space. Everything is simple, smart. Again, this is what you'd call like an entry-level gas Class A, but it's clean, it's sharp, it's certainly not beat up. Not by any stretch of the imagination. I mean, everything in here is spick and span. Let me back up a little bit, give you... No, one thing I did want to point out, the seats. The seats have, unfortunately, a little bit of skin cancer, but you know what? They're okay. There's nothing wrong with the seat. It's just a little unsightly. That is not going to stop you from getting to your destination. So here's a better look at that super slide from the driver's area looking back now. That dinette here. This is a, Jacob calls it a dream dinette, but it's a quick, easy up-down dinette. You see that strut leg system inside of there. Helps the dinette go up and down easily if you are going to convert that into a sleeper. Something else I like is this dual, like this opposing sofa living room right here. It's very social. You know, if you have friends over and you're entertaining guests, the seats face one another, and I really like that, because when I grew up camping, it was all about the personal experiences, and it seems like in today's RV market, everything is centered on, where's the TV? I have to see the TV. But, I don't know, everybody camps differently, so I'm not judging, I'm just stating an observation, I suppose. You see, electronics are all present. Again, everything seems to be working. We have day-night shades, all the windows open for airflow. This is a clean little bugger right here. Walk through middle bathroom. Now, when the slide's closed, that's why the door's on this side. So when the slide comes closed, you can still get to the bathroom and bedroom in transit. And it actually has, I mean, a really generous bathroom cabinet arrangement in here. This is big. I think it's because they didn't get too stupidly oversized on the shower. It's a fine grown adult size shower. It works like a charm, but they didn't make it bigger than it had to be. Now, hiding behind this door right here is a surprisingly good linen cabinet. When you first see it on an angle like this, you're like, oh, not too big. And then you realize it actually goes all the way behind the entertainment center with these nice looking hardwood doors, and that does go all the way to the floor. That little door stopper there is a nice little touch too, so that this door handle right here doesn't bash anything up when you open that. Little decisions like that from the design standpoint make a big difference. Pretty common closet bathroom style here with your little linen cabinet. This extra linen storage right here, though, that is fantastic. So when you do decide to close off and privatize this bathroom, you are good to go. And I love the extra counter space that we have going on here next to that big sink. And again, cleanliness, it shines. I mean, it shines that it's clean. King bed back here kind of rounds out the equation. King bed set across from a whole wall full of storage. That's one of the cool things about this being a king bed. It looks like it was pre-designed with a king, not somebody just tried to shove a king into it. So it still has the ability to be walked around, and I love the big windows for airflow, for light, and just monster closet space. This has some terribly impressive closet space. It's a little different. It's a regular. I mean, I could see somebody saying, I don't like slides on that door side. I like slides on the driver's side. Okay, I get that. But this definitely has a purpose. This is a cool layout. Let's close up the slides and take another peek. All right, a quick peek at her with the slides closed. Now, one thing someone's going to question is they're going to say, now, those slides on this side, they're eating into my campsite. I'm going to have less campsite space. And the answer is no, you won't. Because what you have to remember is without slides on the driver's side of the RV, you can actually position the entire coach closer to the edge of your, I don't know, property line, however you want to phrase that. So depending on how you set things like picnic tables, this may actually maximize your patio space. That's just kind of something to wrap my head around. Now with this slide closed, it is very comfortably navigable. You never feel like you're really cramped in here in any sort of fashion, and it does not have a folding mattress. So if you want to stop overnight somewhere, you want to stop for a couple hours, get the sleep out of your eyes, you can still hop in bed here. Obviously, you're not going to walk around it, but no big deal there either. Now, your slides are individually operated, so if you want to just bump the bed slide, if you have that opportunity, you can do that too. Short of that, give us a call, 800-256-5196, Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.